I am Will Sell, joined by Judy Batista, Sean O'Hara, and Kim Jones. We, of course, are practicing social distancing, not because we don't like each other. Well, Sean, no.
To be determined, by the way, it's AM, not AM.
Exactly.
There you go.
Oh, wow. Mr. Broadcaster over here.
So adding a little levity this morning, obviously we know these are uncertain times. Wherever you are, we just hope you are safe and healthy with family. If there's any way that we can break the monotony of your day, we are here to help, to inform, and hopefully entertain. And boy, was it entertaining to see what was happening last night. If you were sleeping, what were you doing? You missed a lot. First up, Amari Cooper will remain a Cowboy. He gets a huge deal to stay in Dallas on the same day the Cowboys tagged Dak Prescott. More on that from our NFL Network insider Ian Rappaport. And how about this? Stephon Diggs heading to the Bills. And that's only half the story. We're still counting the draft picks the Vikings got in return. We'll delve into that, which raises even more questions about the DeAndre Hopkins trade yesterday that shocked everybody. D-Hop now a Cardinal, and Bill O'Brien has some splaining to do. But right now, doing some splaining for us is our cavalcade of reporters, the best in the business. You see them right there, Ian Rappaport, Tom Pelissero, and, of course, Mike Garofolo. And, Ian, let's start with Amari Cooper. We know that both sides there in Dallas were working on a deal. Amari Cooper had said over and over he'd like to be a Cowboy for a long time, and he finally got his wish.
Yeah, this one really was getting done all the way. It was just a matter of getting to that number. And the Cowboys knew right from the very beginning that if they got to the $20 million per year number, that Amari Cooper was going back to Dallas. It's where he wanted to be. He basically changed his career, revived his career after being traded from the then Oakland Raiders to the Dallas Cowboys for a first-round pick. And, of course, for the Cowboys, they are aware of how different things are when he is on the field and healthy. Just a matter of arriving to the right numbers. They did that late last night. The Redskins also had some interest, but it sounds like they knew that whatever happened, Cooper was going back to Dallas. In the end, 5 years, $100 million for Amari Cooper, $60 million in guarantees. And he stays in Dallas, and of course, Dak Prescott as well with the exclusive tag.
And of course, that wasn't the only wide receiver news that we received last night. Tom, some big news coming out of Buffalo.
That's right, Will. And this really didn't heat up until last night with the Minnesota Vikings sending Stephon Diggs to Buffalo along with a seventh-round draft pick. In exchange, Minnesota gets a first-round pick, number 22 in this draft, as well as fifth- and sixth-round picks and a fourth-round pick out in 2021. Now, the Vikings were insistent throughout the offseason that they were not motivated to deal Diggs, even after some things that happened last year, going AWOL, getting fined. He did improve in terms of how he was around the building. After that, they were not going to let him go unless they got a significant haul. Well, that's exactly what Buffalo came to the table with. Minnesota now has resources to fill other holes on their roster. They have more flexibility in a draft that is really good at the wide receiver position, and they also have less drama from the tweets and everything else. Buffalo, meanwhile, gets a proven commodity here, a guy with back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons, still only 26 years old, a player they think will be able to help their young quarterback, Josh Allen.
And Tom, this was after we had a wild trade that many have broken down in DeAndre Hopkins going from the Texans to the Cardinals with David Johnson coming back. Texans getting themselves a second-round pick as well to take on that salary that was fully guaranteed for David Johnson. But the real story here for many is how does Bill O'Brien let DeAndre Hopkins go? And the answer is multi-pronged, one of which is that Hopkins had 3 years and $40 million remaining on his deal. Everybody loves these contracts early on when they get the big numbers. Then they see the smaller numbers and go, wait a second. Julio Jones just got his deal done with 2 years left. He's into the 20s on an average per year. I'm looking at an average of like 13 over the next 3 years. I want a new deal. And O'Brien's saying, we're not going to do that. These two have also not seen eye to eye at times. So O'Brien says, you know what? I'm going to move on. And then I'm going to bring myself in David Johnson, whom he still believes can be a dual threat, unlike he was, or excuse me, like he he was a couple of years ago, unlike last year with the Cardinals. And O'Brien better be right about this, because the heat is already on him. He's made a number of deals. People have questioned the return. They are questioning the return on this one as well.
That they are. Twitter was going crazy over this.
Can I jump in make a real quick point?
Yep.
One thing about Bill O'Brien, and I know everyone is scrutinizing DeAndre Hopkins, and how did they not get more? O'Brien shopped DeAndre Hopkins very aggressively but very quietly at the trade deadline and early on in February, really for the last several weeks. This is the most he could get. So maybe he shouldn't have traded him. I don't know. But I'm just saying he couldn't get more because teams were not willing to offer more.
All right, fair point there. Ian, Tom, Mike G, thank you very much. There were a lot of people on Twitter that were wondering what was going on, including our Adam Rank. David Johnson for DeAndre Hopkins would get vetoed in most fantasy leagues with the team managers barred for life. This would be 100% facts, my friends. Oh, wow, from Kenyon Drake with the eye-popping emoji there. And 10 plus 11 plus 13 equals scary sight. Welcome to the squad, bro. Let's eat at DeAndre Hopkins. That, of course, from Kirk and Jalen Ramsey. What? What? So a lot of varying reactions, but they all were the same. They just could have used the shoulder emoji as well. When this news came down, we were thinking, man, oh, man, this feels one-sided with the Cardinals, which I know Steve Weiss, who's watching, fabulous report for us, said this was straight-up thievery, Judy, by the Cardinals.
Can somebody please post a video of, I have to assume Kyler Murray is cartwheeling around his house right now.
Oh, absolutely.
At the prospect of getting with these wide receivers. It's fantastic for a young quarterback. It's a fantastic deal for Arizona. Look, I'm interested in what Ian said, that they'd been shopping Hopkins for a while and this is the best they could do. I wanted to bring up our own Mike Giardi, who I hope has gloves by this time for when he gets out there in Foxborough today, tweeted a few minutes ago that the Patriots quietly checked in on both Diggs and Hopkins, but they simply were not willing to surrender the capital it was going to require to get them. The capital that was given up for Hopkins was not much.
You got to surrender
that. That's for sure. You know, you wonder about that. I think Bill O'Brien is going to have to answer for this trade for a long time. If you couldn't get more than this,
how is that possible?
Then why do you?
How is that possible?
Because everybody knew, I assume, that he's going to want another a big deal. But then hold on to him. I mean, this is a top two receiver.
But one of the more interesting parts of that hearing from our insiders was what Ian said at the end. Trade deadline, he tried to shop him. That changes the entire 2019 season.
Absolutely.
If that happens. He changed games down the stretch. He changed games in the playoffs. I mean, against the Bills. I mean, that to me was the remarkable part. And maybe back then it was a second and it just never improved. So he decided to go ahead and get the deal done. But it feels like he traded David Copperfield for a bag of tricks.
Yeah.
Because DeAndre Hopkins is a magician.
Yeah, because David Blaine ain't coming, right? Straight up, right? That's not going to work out, right? And
yeah.
You're
so funny. You're so funny.
I don't know why. I just thought of David Blaine. But you look at this, and reportedly they had issues there in Houston. So if you are a teammate of DeAndre Hopkins and you're seeing this unfold, don't you say to yourself, these two men have to work this out. This is a singular talent that we
but
have.
But who's
here
going to say that?
Yeah.
Bill
O'Brien right
has as much power as
right
any coach
the final
in the league next
that's
to Bill
exactly
Belichick.
Right.
No,
absolutely
that's a good
right
point, though. I had you more of a Chris Angel guy, but
oh, I love him.
No,
the stink eye right now that Bill O'Brien's going to get when he is finally able to walk into that building and into that locker room. I mean, the guys on that team, to your point, Kim, they wouldn't have been in the playoffs last year.
No, not without DeAndre Hopkins. No,
like, think about
close
it. Will Fuller was hurt. When Deshaun Watson was running around trying to save his life, he was looking for DeAndre Hopkins. So the ripple effect from this trade, I don't know if it's going to be worth it. And, you know, I mean, think about it like this. You know, you're a father. You got four kids, all right? You've got an unbelievably state-of-the-art SUV. The kids are watching TV in the background. They got their own headphones. They each get to watch their own show. And you just traded that in for a 1986 sheepdog all right, and a station wagon, that now they have nothing to do. So you're going to have to answer for these angry kids that are going to be throwing stuff at you for the next 8 hours in the car.
Here's what I have to believe, though, you know, to craft what Bill O'Brien has to be thinking is he got a second back, right? He has to be thinking that in this draft, I'm not saying you're going to get DeAndre Hopkins. Right. I'm saying, to me, that has to have played a role here, that he believes he can get a young player who is going to be highly talented. They're going to be receivers go, you know, in the fourth round that are really talented in this draft. So he has to believe he can get something to where Deshaun Watson has a playmaker to work with. That's the only way this even partly makes sense to me. The only way is because of what this draft represents at the receiver position.
And it's a huge gamble. You know, I mean, look, let's rewind actually to last year when the Giants traded Odell Beckham to the Cleveland Browns. I mean, people took the Giants and Dave Gettleman to task, and he got a first rounder, a third rounder, and Jabril Peppers. And
it's too early to
look
judge.
You look at that trade, and compared to the whole of what they got with Arizona.
Right.
I mean, this is, you know, it's
right. The holes are not comparable. The other thing about David Johnson is I know it's a second back for them, but he had one productive season and he's 3 years removed from that
season now. That's right.
We have no idea if he can get anywhere close to that again.
He's been hurt a lot. Will Fuller is always
hurt. And Fuller's always hurt. And if he's your guy
to find a way,
he's your guy.
He's got to be your number one while a rookie develops, right? I mean, you think.
And the Texans continue to look for a running back, too. Lamar Miller, Carlos Hyde.
Here we go.
David Johnson.
One thing, because I don't know if we're getting back to the Cardinals today. I actually still hope they draft CeeDee Lamb,
right? Which would be insane.
Which would be crazy.
Then you say,
just go and we dare one of you in this league to be able to cover them. Yeah.